गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। सो लेट मी स्टार्ट माय टुडे सेशन दैट इज़ ऑन अल्टरनेट करियर ऑप्शंस इन व्हाइल परसुइंग बीटेक इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग। गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रिसीव हैप्पी रक्षाबंधन फ्रॉम माई साइड एंड माई बेस्ट विशेस टू यू ऑल फॉर बीइंग विद मी एंड ज्वाइनिंग दिस सेशन। गुड इवनिंग गदब, गुड इवनिंग एवरी वन। सो माई टूडे सेशन इज ऑन अल्टरनेट करियर ऑप्शन इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग एंड आई वुड लाइक टू फर्स्ट डिस्कस द मोटिवेशन बिहाइंड दिस सेशन एंड देन वाई दीज सेशंस आर इम्पॉर्टेंट। सो आई एम गोइंग टू हैव अ सीरीज ऑफ सेशंस लाइक टूडे आई विल बी कवरिंग। गुड इवनिंग अमित मलिक। सो टूडे आई विल बी कवरिंग one aspect of alternate career options and in subsequent episodes I will be covering other aspects also. So today I will be talking about career option, that is animation. So let me first discuss my motivation, because when I go to the classes and ask my students, those who are pursuing civil engineering, so when I ask the question to them, whether you have taken this profession as a whether you have taken this profession as by chance or by choice, so I surprised to see that more than 85% students, they say that it was by chance, and only 15-20% students, they just say that it was my choice, because I have background and I know what I want to do when I have chosen civil engineering as a profession. So now you see that bulk is in by chance. So they think that somehow they are into this profession, and then they actually struggle that because of their parents, because of their peer pressure, because of other reason, maybe they are not too good in other profession, or they think that they will not be able to survive in other profession, so they have taken civil engineering. And then later they really struggle, and then they are actually not very clear that what they should do, what they should pursue. So just after 2-3 years of engineering, they start thinking, and then they find that okay, something is there for them. So it's like herd movement, so they see that okay, jo baki log kar rahe hain wahi chalo hum bhi kar lete hain. So it is like that. So I thought that why not to give options, why not discuss options, various options that are available for a civil engineering graduate student, so that they can plan well in advance, they can acquire the required skill sets, they can acquire the required knowledge, and what kind of core competency that is required in a particular field to venture, what kind of learning should be there, what kind of certifications that are required, and how they should prepare for this, because they easily get motivated by seeing video movies like Three Idiots, but then they think that this is okay, because all the messages are now going on viral that you follow your passion, you follow your dreams, you follow your motivation, and work in the field where you want to. But then what happens that व्हाट टू डू, करें क्या. लेकिन चैलेंज ये आता है कि देर इज़ नो गाइडेंस अवेलेबल टू देम, देर इज़ नो, बिकॉज एवरीवेयर वेयर एवर यू गो एंड इफ यू एक्सप्लोर दैट दे लुक फॉर स्किल सेट्स, दे लुक फॉर एक्सपीरियंस, दे लुक फॉर सर्टिफिकेशन, सो मेनी थिंग्स आर देयर. सो आई थॉट दैट let us talk about various options that are there with us and why not to guide them in time so that they can prepare themselves for the purpose. So to add to this, actually recently we were involved in creating, because now you see that the teaching learning is going on online, so we as a teacher we also have to prepare some online content, like we have to prepare videos, animated videos, or sometimes we have to create some graphics or other things that we normally create with the help of technical support that is available to us. And recently we were also involved in creating videos for civil engineering products like paver blocks, bricks, ready mix concrete for our first year students who were given a new course, that is experience it yourself. So with me, Dr. Nishant, my colleague, and Mr. Vidyasagar, they were involved, and we actually learned how to get involved into these things, because we visited the site, we recorded the process, we recorded the videos, but then we realized that lot of editing work is required. Even you will not believe that a 3 minutes of video requires 30 hours of hard work. So lot of video editing, lot of voiceover recording was there, animations were required to show the process, and then stitching videos. We were also involved in the studio recording. So then I realized that and then the challenge was that a person who was doing the editing work, he was not from the civil engineering background, so he was not able to understand the technical details or technicalities of the issues or the challenges that were there. So he was just like a normal technical person who is not aware of the, he was good in stitching and editing, but he was not able to apply his own mind that how the things should be done. So there we faced challenge, and then I thought, I realized that if a civil engineer is involved in creating these kind of videos and these kind of online content, then definitely that gives a kind of backup to. So why not a civil engineer can or a BTech person who is doing BTech in civil engineering can get into this animation business and then get trained themselves and then give the right input, and then he or she himself can do the editing work, create the videos, and then and they can earn a lot, and they can, these are all alternative options that are available. So I think lot of scope is there in the coming time, because now world is moving towards online education, online teaching learning, and then definitely it is going to stay with us, because you know lot of platforms that are available for students, for children who are actually learning online in a much better way, in a much better with much better understanding than normal teaching learning that goes in the classroom. From that point of view, I should say that one should explore the options that are definitely available. So I will be covering one by one various options, various options that are available for the civil engineer. And don't think that your basic degree in civil engineering is going to be waste. It is not going to be waste, because you need to find the right channel where you can get involved, and then you can you can see that how your technical input actually helps in creating those educational videos or educational content that is there, that is now, this is the demand of the time. So I have seen many of my friends who are actually involved into these kind of alternate career options, like they are working in they have done BTech in civil engineering, and then after that they are working in the field of artificial intelligence, machine learning. They are into automation, big data, augmented virtual reality or mixed reality. They are working on sensor technologies, cloud computing. They are also involved in software developments, big data, and there are so many options are available. So many things are to be done. So let us talk one by one that what exactly you can do while pursuing your. So this particular session will be helpful for those students who are actually in their first year or second year of their BTech degree program, and they are looking for the alternate career options that are available to them. And one option is animation. And in the today's session, I will be talking about in detail about this profession, and then where you can actually venture, and you can get into. So you all know that majority of the things, majority of animations and this work are very much utilized in the field of films, televisions, advertising, digital advertising, online media, print media, gaming, e-learning. So majority of the content which is covered in the session will be related to the e-learning, because e-learning is related to the online teaching learning, and e-learning contents are developed and by the professionals who are expert in the field. And if you want to create content related to civil engineering profession, like and you want to create, somebody is interested to create content on e-learning, then definitely you can be contacted, or you can contact them, and you can show your talent, you can show your expertise, you can show your experience, and get into involved in that. So let us see that what are the different options that are available in the field of animation. You can work as animator. You can also work as game designer, because it's not game like creating PUBG game. You see that lot of video games are available for civil engineering students, where through video game they try to learn various aspects of civil engineering. So, like one of the video game that I have seen, that there will be two hill, and then the video game will ask to add the structural component to construct a bridge, and then they will the vehicle will pass on the bridge, and then it will assess that whether the bridge that is created by you is safe or not. So like that, these kind of video games are available in the market. You can just Google search civil engineering video games, and you will find lot of options. So you can be a game designer, you can be a graphic designer, you can be graphic production artist, you can be VFX artist. So these are the different options that are available in the field of animation. So as an animator, first of all, you should understand that you should have a genuine interest into the art and design. If you think that you have a genuine interest in the field of art and design, you have good sound IT skills, and you can give lot of attention to the work, and then you can concentrate on a little longer period. So definitely you can think of your career as an animator in the field of animation. So normally what happens that you know that how the animations are created. Those who are involved into the technology and techniques, they know much better than me, because I'm not an animator, or I'm not a person who works in the field of animation. But definitely some of the things that I have Google searched, and I found the content from the net, so I will be trying to present. I may be technically wrong sometimes, but I will try my level best to give you the right information. So you know that animation is a kind of multi-step process in which you have to generate ideas, and then you work in the on the planning part. Then there is a pre-production stage to translate the script or ideas to a visual format, and then shot by shot you take the entire story, and then there is a storyboard or a stop frame animation and their base to add movement and personality to the models. And then there is a digital painter to add color. There are various layers of animation that are then joined together, and then they are to add lights, textures, soundtracks, everything. So it's a multi-step process. So you can be involved in any one of the process, or you can be given a total project for an animation. So you must have seen a lot of animated videos in 2D and 3D with the special effects. So these things are normally, if you see the cartoons, if you see the music videos, advertisement, computer games, website animations or music videos, so there they actually use this animation technology, and they use some computer tools and softwares to develop these kind of animation, animated videos or graphics. So what exactly is required here? Here you have to actually do some kind of, I will not be talking about the degree program or diploma program which is there in the animation field, because you are already doing a degree program in the field of civil engineering. So for you, if you are interested in the field of animation, then definitely you should think of certification. So you can do certification programs, you can get certification, you do internship in the field of animation, so that you can explore that that potential that you have in you. So you can think of some of the certification programs that are offered by the institutions, and especially in the field of VFX, digital composting, or video editing, or After Effects. So these kind of certification programs are given by the private institutions or organizations. From 1 month to 6 months, you can take that and you can get the certification. And then it's not only getting the certificate only. After that, you can actually do the internship, so that you can brush up whatever learning you have done. You can do the brushing, and then you can have your own projects, create some small projects or things that you can showcase. So you have to involve yourself. धीरे धीरे अपने आप को involve करना पड़ेगा, धीरे धीरे चीज़ें सीखनी पड़ेगी, and you have to work with people who are good in this field. But definitely, if you think कि now you want to create a career in this field, so definitely इसके बाद you can do post graduation in the field of animation, or you can do also PhD, and then you can become a faculty in one of the institutions who are offering this program on animation. So for that, what you have to do, you have to clear a national level exam which is conducted by IIT Bombay. So they conduct every year, they conduct All India Common Entrance Examination for Design, CEED. Okay, so this is a qualifying examination that has to be cleared if you want to do PG in the reputed institutions like IIT or NITs or any other great institution, that those who recognize this CEED examination, and then they take admission through this examination. So there you have to clear this exam first, and then you can get into this profession, and then you can do PG. After that, you can also do PhD, and then you can explore and work in this field of animation. So the most important thing is that you should have a genuine interest of art and design, and you should be good on learning softwares, and you should, because definitely all these works are done on software, so you have to learn a lot of softwares, and some of the software that are most widely used, so that has to be learned. And then after that, you can work in many fields, many areas. That all depends upon your exposure and your interest. But definitely, one thing is important, that you can work in the field of e-learning, developing e-learning content for the educational institution, for the purpose. Nowadays, a lot of education institutions or private organizations or private labs, animation labs are there in metro cities, and they are creating a lot of e-learning content for the educational institutions. And there you can join the hand and you can learn the things and you can grow in this field. So that is one option as animator in the field of animation. You can also be a freelancer. You can provide services to others as a freelancer. So there you can charge on your own. You can be your own boss, and you can explore that also. And if you want to be a salaried person, definitely you have to join some private or organization or private lab or institution. So there you can, with experience and with exposure, you can earn up to 10 lakhs per annum, so even more than that. But then definitely that requires a lot of skills, expertise, and exposure to the work. And with experience, you grow in this field. So that is one option. Second option, you can think of as a game designer. As I mentioned earlier also, that there is a normal game, there's video game or computer games are there. Or nowadays mobile games are there. So I'm not talking in terms of that. If you have interest, definitely you can go. There is no restriction on that. You can go and you can explore. But I was thinking more into the technical aspect, because I have seen a lot of gaming videos. Video games are there. That you can see in the field of civil engineering also. Like, you just Google search and you will find a lot of video games that are created for the civil engineering profession, where first year or second year students learn the technicalities of civil engineering through that video game. Although it is not very popular, it is an upcoming field. Slowly it will definitely penetrate into the educational field, and then you will be seeing that a lot of students are learning the civil engineering through these video games, because that makes the session very interactive, very interesting, and they learn small things through this gaming, and then they find that there is no need of explaining them the things in a boring lecture. So that's the plus point of these kind of animated videos and games. So what should be a skill that you should think that you can be a good game designer? First of all, you should have very excellent drawing skills, and you should have a good understanding of programming language, software programs. Some of the softwares like 3D Max and Maya, these two are the most important softwares that are used in the profession. So you should be proficient in these softwares. One is 3D Max and another is Maya. Then you should have good understanding of basic visual design and drawing skills. And you should have the ability to work in a team, and you should have good interpersonal skills, and a lot of because you have to work in a team. When you want to see yourself as a game designer, so it is a blend of talent, technology, and creativity. So you have to be excellent there. So lot of options are there for you. If you want to be a game designer, you can think on that also. Once you do the certification, you can, as a game designer, you can also do the degree program, diploma program. As I mentioned that I will be not talking about the degree and diploma programs here, because you are already doing one degree program, that is BTech in civil engineering. But definitely you can do certification program in these softwares that I have just mentioned. 3D Max, Maya, you can do certification program there. You can get certification program on basic visual design, and other things are inherent. It is all that inside. If you have those talents, like working for in a team, and you have a creativity in you, then you can think about this option also. So this is one thing. Good evening, Amit Sharma ji. Kaushalendra, good evening. Praveen, good evening. Praveen Singh ji, good evening. Saroj, good evening, Saroj. Janki, Dr. Janki, good evening. Pavan Kumar, good evening. Dr. Shilpi, good evening. So, Prasanna, good evening, Prasanna. So, this one option that I have two options that I have already discussed. One is you can work as an animator, and second is you can work as a game designer. Now, the third option is graphic designer. You know that these graphic designers are basically they help business communicate with the consumers. They use imaginaries, use logos, and they give some kind of instant picture to the mind of the consumers or customers about the product. So graphic design is another option. You must have seen graphic designs on different labels, packages, billboards, or even openings of the films also, and they use these kind of graphic designing. So good evening, Sanjeev Jain. So you can explore various options, and nowadays, because you know that जो दिखता है वही दिखता है आजकल के समय में, तो advertising बहुत ज़्यादा हो गई है, बहुत ज़्यादा advertising की जाती है. इनफैक्ट प्राइवेट institutions आर गुड इन टू दिस, बहुत advertising करते हैं, एंड देन दे डेफिनेटली लुक फॉर टैलेंटेड पीपल हु कैन वर्क एज ग्राफिक डिजाइनर, एंड दे पे ए गुड अमाउंट टू दैम. सो फॉर ए ग्राफिक डिजाइनर यू शुड डेफिनेटली हैव ए बेसिक ड्राइंग स्किल. You should have good creativity. Your imagination should be very strong, and you should be eager to learn. You should be observant, and you should have a different eye for all kind of details or detailing. And one important thing that you should have you should be proficient, and you should be knowledgeable in the field of graphic design software. So everywhere it is invariably used. Software skills and software computing programming is important. Knowledge of programming, visual basics, and software learning. These are all important because these are all invariably used in the field of animation and graphic design. And soft skill, you should have a good listening and communication skills, because you have to patiently listen what the customer demands, and then accordingly you have to. Yes, definitely, Prasanna. I will arrange one session on concrete mix design. It is a long pending request from your side. I am going to handle this session. I'll ask one of my expert to take the session on concrete mix design, because my field is geotechnical engineering. I may not be able to give you that input that is required for concrete mix design, but definitely I have experts with me who can deliver a good session on concrete mix design. Even I can try to arrange people from the industry who can actually give session on concrete mix design. So thank you very much for your request. I'll see that I meet your demand. So again, there are various courses are available in the field of graphic design. But definitely I suggest that you go for certification courses in the field of graphic design, in the field of softwares, like you have to be very good in tools and softwares like Photoshop. Photoshop is one of the most important software which is used for the graphic design. Photoshop hai, Coral Draw hai, ye sab software aapko thode se seekhne padenge. Ispe aapko proficiency lani padegi. Software learning is one thing. One, I have seen many of my students, so they attend some center and then they spend 50 hours or 60 hours of duration, they get the certificate, and after that they will add their certificate in the biodata file, and after that they will forget. So until unless you become proficient, until unless you jab tak apne haath aap saaf nahi karoge, uski safai, haath ki safai jaise kehte hain na, you have to be very very proficient in using those software. So jab tak wo cheez nahi aayegi, aur wo that you will only learn when you work with somebody, you work, you take internship opportunities in the field of graphic designer, and then you see that how the things are different for you. So learn these softwares, Coral Draw, Photoshop, and see that if you have these kind of skills in you, drawing skills, creativity, imagination, and then you can definitely go for this. You have to assess yourself. That I keep telling to everyone, that first you assess yourself and then you jump into the don't close your eyes and jump. You see that what you can do, what your inner what is your inner strength, and what exactly you can do, and then only you jump. Otherwise keep a trainer with you who can help you and train you so that you grow with time. Let us talk about the fourth option, which is there in the field of career in animation, in the field of animation, that is graphic production artist. So again, a very upcoming field where in this particular field there is an extensive use of softwares, like in the field of graphic production artist. So it's a kind of technical job in the creative industry, and there they actually handle the graphic design works and like in creation and in production. So there are two different areas are there. One is creation and one is production. So basically, as a graphic designer, you can convey the idea to the client, and then with the help of visual effects you can create the desired projects. So they actually use a lot of their technical skills and computer skills to meet the client expectations. So that is very important. And the softwares that are most widely used in this field are Adobe Photoshop, QuarkPress, image editing, Adobe Illustrator, drawing, InDesign, page layout, and Adobe Acrobat PDF editing. So you should be a Adobe certified expert in this field. If you want to venture into the field of graphic production artist, you should be a Adobe certified expert. Then only you can think of. So try to get certification if you want to excel, if you want to explore in the field of graphic production artist, you want to be a graphic production artist, then definitely you get the certification of Adobe Certified Expert, ACE. Then you can work in the in many fields like magazines, newspaper, web design companies, film industry, corporate houses, in-house art departments, anywhere, advertising agencies, lot of options are there. And now, as I mentioned that with online teaching learning, lot of advertising material is also required for the e-content, delivery of the e-content, e-learning. So there also you can explore. And then there is another option in animation, that is called visual effect artist, VFX. You must have seen a lot of movies like Jurassic Park is one of the best example where you must have seen the effect of VFX, and a lot of recent movies, in every movie they use this VFX effect, and all the higher budget movies they actually do this. So VFX is a technology where special effects, animations are there, or entire cleanups are done by the visual effect artist, so through animation and VFX, and suppose as a student, I just want to get into the beam, inside the beam, and I want to see the reinforcement, how it is done. So that is a great idea, I think. As a civil engineer, I can get into the beam, I can get inside the beam, I can see how the reinforcements are given, how the things are happening, even if it is bending or shear or torsion is there, how the beams are bending. And so many things are actually shown through animations and through this VFX effect, where you can do animation and you can do like how the things are moving. So all the processes can be explained through animation. So there you have to require certification in the 3D modeling, computer animation or graphics. So that is the major requirement. Unless you do this kind of certification and you do the internship program on this, it will be difficult. So I will suggest that please explore and get certification in the field of 3D modeling, computer animation and graphics, and do software courses, certification courses in other softwares that are used. And some of the experienced people, they mentioned that you have to master in three fields. One is software, tool used. So in this VFX artist, you have to be proficient in the using these tools, and most widely used tools are, software tools are Flame, Shape, Maya, Flash, Nuke. So these are the softwares which are used actually in the field of VFX. So you should be good in using these softwares, and then you should have a very good eye for creativity, for photorealistic effects, and then you should be good in composting techniques. So composition techniques is very important, because you have to be do a lot of things on blue screening, keying, motion tracking, and like that. So a lot of things are there that you have to learn. So unless you get into this, it will be difficult. So I have almost covered all the aspects of career in animation, where I discussed job profiles, process, roles, responsibilities, educational qualifications, and if any examinations, interest examination is there. So everything is discussed in detail. You can be as an animator, you can work as animator, you can work as game designer, you can work as graphic designer, you can work as graphic production artist, you can be a visual effects artist, but the only thing and the most important thing is that you should be proficient in using software tools. Some of the software that I mentioned in this session, you should be very good and proficient in that. You should be very strong in creativity, you should be very strong in designs, you should be very strong in teamwork, you should be very strong in working for long hours, because in these kind of profession lot of pressures and deadlines are there. So you should be good working in pressure, and you can concentrate for long hours, because you have to sit in front of computer and you have to do a lot of editing work and software work for long hours. So you should have that capability to work for long hours. But these are all highly paid professions. So if you can show your capability and talent, you can definitely earn more than 15 lakhs, 15 to 20 lakhs per per annum. That will initially it may not be so high, but then with experience and with knowledge and with good project, if you work on good projects, then definitely you can work a lot and you can earn a lot in, when you opt this profession. So I think I should thank you all once again. Explore all the possibilities and your potential. I always tell to everyone in my session that there is no shortcut to success, and dedication and hard work, these are the two key words, I should say, that that are key to success. So your dedication and your hard work can take you anywhere. And I have seen many young generation that they want to become boss overnight. So it is not possible until unless it takes time, and you follow your passion and then see that the surprises are waiting for you. So I wish you all the best. Good luck. We will meet in the next session, in the next episode, with discussion in the different field. Till then, take care. Goodbye. Thank you very much for being with me. Thanks a lot.